Hey tech lovers, welcome back to another fresh episode of Mobile Funda. I know this update review is a bit late because we are busy with the HyperOS 3 videos. So thanks a lot for waiting. And I have been using this HyperOS 2.2 update on my Note 13 Pro 5G for about 11 to 12 days. And today I will share the full review with you. So let's begin. By the way, if you are new to the channel, then don't forget to hit that subscribe button and press the bell icon so that you keep getting videos on Note 13 Pro 5G in the future as well. So first up is animation. The UI feels smooth and after the new launcher, it looks even better. But the sad part is that the lock screen wallpaper animation is gone and the web animation is still not there. So yes, animations are smoother but is still not complete. And when the animations are not fully satisfying, the next thing we all want to check is performance. So in daily app usage, the phone works fine and the RAM management is also like before. But one thing shocked me, the AnTuTu score was only 5.54 lakh. Which is very low as compared to Chinese region. Heating is also there and you can feel it clearly. For example, in PUBG with Smooth Plus Extreme setting, the game runs fine in the beginning. But after 10 to 15 minutes, the phone heats a lot. So for daily use, it is okay. But heating makes you think about how the battery will perform. So the battery backup for me is almost the same as before, means no big change. Charging speed is also the same. But what surprised me is the idle battery drain, which is around 7 to 10%, especially at night. Now I know many users said their battery backup reduced after the update. But in my case, I had already applied almost all restrictions and optimizations. Maybe that's why it feels the same as before. And yes, no improvement here. Now the next hope is with the camera. So the camera app now looks new with a fresh design. But the picture quality and optimization are exactly the same. The dedicated 200MP option is also missing, which feels like a step back. So overall the app feels different, but the result don't. And when the camera also doesn't improve, then the next focus is connectivity. So the connectivity is a mix. 5G still fluctuates, which is not good. But Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and hotspot are working fine without any problems. Still one thing is missing, that is YouTube HDR support, which many users have been waiting since a long time. And with that, this update also brings some new bugs. And yes, new bugs are there. First, sometimes the phone lags, especially when applying backup or third-party themes, which was not the case before. Second, backup and restore also doesn't work properly, sometimes with the third-party file manager. And the most irritating one is the phone randomly auto-reboots. So instead of fixing old issues, Xiaomi has added some new ones. So overall, the HyperOS 2.2 update on Note 13 Pro 5G feels like a mixed update. Animations are smoother but not complete. Performance is okay but heating is a problem. Battery is the same for me but idle drain is high. The camera app looks new but quality is unchanged. Connectivity is fine except 5G, and finally new bugs also came in. So let's see what Xiaomi gives in the next update, maybe in the September patch. Hopefully some real fixes. So that's all for today's video. I hope today's funda was clear. If yes, then like this video and share it with your Note 13 Pro 5G or Poco X6 5G friends. And of course, subscribe to Mobile Funda for more Note 13 Pro 5G videos in the future. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Till then, keep exploring. Jai Hind.